Hello there. Welcome to D-Light Channel, Development, Empowerment and Leadership Initiative, an NGO where our vision is world transformation, one man at a time, one community at a time. Thank you for making it a date with me again this week. We have been focusing on organizational life cycle, and over the last couple of weeks, we have touched on the startup phase, and we are midway down the line on the growth phase. Of course, in between, we took a detour to focus on brand development because I think that was necessary. However, as we come back onto the main course that we are focusing on, which is the organizational life cycle, maybe you are wondering, why do we think this topic is necessary? We have been focusing on it because we think that beyond just self-employment, your focus should be on entrepreneurship. And if it's entrepreneurship, then you should be interested in building an enterprise. And in building an enterprise, you will do better if you are aware of what will happen in your journey towards building a sustainable organization. So this week, we get back to the phase that we call the growth phase. Now, as it sounds, growth is the point where you are increasing and you are expanding. The market has accepted the idea, you have validated your thoughts, you are experimenting with your initiatives, and customers are buying and they're paying, and you are increasing. But the growth phase has two sides. The first side is where you are increasing at an increasing rate. That is where everything is expanding. You are moving very, very quickly. But somewhere down the line, if you are paying attention, you will notice that you are still increasing, but now at a decreasing rate. Yeah? So you are still opening new outlets. Your volume is still increasing. Your customer base is still increasing, but not as fast as it was during the first half of the growth phase. When you are at that phase, you are beginning to slow down. And ultimately, you are going to end up on the maturity phase. I will come to that in a minute. But when you find out that you are increasing at a reducing rate, what should you be doing? The meaning of that is that, one, you are approaching maturity. And if you are approaching maturity, it then means that you need to be deliberate about every step you take at that point. You can no longer afford careless, wasteful decisions. Every wrong move becomes a bit more expensive. Why? As your organization gets bigger, your response time gets shorter. So by the time you are realizing that something has gone wrong, you probably have many more gone wrong already that you do not know as at that time. So when you find out that you are increasing at a reducing rate, you need to then bring into play all the things that we have said at the startup and the first half of the growth phase, meaning your culture, your values, your vision, technology must now play a role, a very active role in guiding your organization. But one more thing you need to be deliberate about here is that this is a phase where your business process now need to be well documented, clearly articulated, and properly enforced. I say that again. Business process, which is the body of activities and actions that clearly defines what is to be done, that clearly defines who is to do it, that clearly defines how it is to be done, that clearly defines the necessary checks, balances, approvals, documentation needed for things, now needs to have been properly documented. Remember, I'm not saying you should know them. I'm saying you should have them documented. And when they are documented, they become a very important part of your organizational asset and resource. Everything you do in your business must be consistent with your business process. Every new employee joining your organization starts from studying, understanding, and following the business process. Let me sound a warning here. Because you have a documented set of business process does not mean that you are throwing away initiative, you are throwing away creativity, you are throwing away agility, you are throwing away flexibility. No. But it means that if your business process is going to change, it must not be ad hoc. It cannot be one person in one corner just choosing to ignore the business process. If there is a need for change, the business process itself will have had built into it the change process that says that if something is not working, something is standing in the way of speed and efficiency, we will review it like this. It goes through this level of approval and then it becomes the new norm. If you do not have a properly defined and documented business process that is baked into your technology, that is baked into the way your organization works, as you get bigger, every wrong move becomes more expensive. Your process of correcting errors becomes very, very cumbersome. So this is the phase one where you need to get that body of knowledge called your business process documented, enforced, implemented. Then secondly, it is the phase where you now start getting ready for the maturity phase. I will get to the maturity phase in the next video. But when you become matured, the meaning is that you will not see a lot of growth. You won't see a lot of expansion. You will more or less have hit the plateau where everything will more or less be the same they are. When you compare your revenue figures month on month, year on year, there will be very, very marginal movement if you are not already declining. When you compare your spread, you will not see many new branches springing up. When you compare your customer base, plus, minus, you will most likely end up about the same number. Now, as you are beginning to see, slow down. Before you hit the plateau, that's the point you now need to start asking yourself, how can you reinvent the business? What new thing can you introduce? What new opportunities can you begin to pursue? Remember that things don't just become successful the day you think about them. So, having the heads up of the slowdown to identify new opportunities, they could be completely new ideas, they could be expansion of what you're currently doing, they could be optimization of what you are currently doing. Whatever you need to do to create a new life for your organization, it is at this second half of the growth phase that you need to start dealing with them and start worrying about them. So, what are those opportunities you need to consider? What is the maturity phase all about? How do you prepare for the maturity phase? And how do you ensure that it does not then end up in decline for you? Those are the things we will be covering in the next video. I am sure you do not want to miss it. So spread the word, share this video with your links. Let us know how you are also connecting with us. And by the way, if you need help on how to document and implement business process for your organization, please get in touch. We are happy to help you with that in whatever manner or form you will require the assistance. Thanks for being here once again this week. It's always a pleasure to have you here. T-Mark is still my name. And don't ever forget that all I'm trying to do is what? Make a little difference. See you next week and bye.